University of Toronto professor Jordan Peterson has become a phenomenon. That's not an overstatement. Videos featuring him online get millions of views. His book, 12 Rules for Life, An Antidote to Chaos, is one of the biggest, maybe the biggest bestseller ever written by a Canadian author. In that book, Peterson questions the left's rhetoric on gender, and maybe for that, he's being targeted for destruction. The Guardian calls him dangerous. Vox just published a massive and almost unbelievably stupid piece accusing Peterson of, quote, reactionary politics that validate white, straight, and cisgender men at the expense of everyone else. Really mouth-breathingly stupid, but there you have it. Jordan Peterson joins us tonight. Professor, thanks for coming on. So obviously a hurt dog barks. You've done something that has made people upset. What do you think you've said that the left finds so provocative and upsetting?
Well, I've pointed out quite clearly why they're factually incorrect and ideologically possessed. I mean, particularly on issues like gender. The radical lefties insist that gender is a social construct, and that's just simply not true. So the scientific data on that are absolutely crystal clear, and no reasonable scientist disagrees. And so they're all foaming at the mouth because I'm poking holes in their cherished notions. And they like to think that people are completely malleable because that means people can be made over in their ideological image. So they're not happy about that.
So when they say your ideas are dangerous, what they're really saying is your ideas are dangerous to them.
I hope so. They're supposed to be dangerous to them. I make no bones about that. I'm not a fan of radical leftists. And look at what happened in the 20th century with radical leftist ideology.
What has your job been like back in academia? I mean, you can't be one of many people who has these views where you live and work.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, I think they're more common than you think. I mean, my views on gender, for example, and sex, they're shared widely among people in the psychometric personality community. Anybody who studies personality and who's a credible scientist knows full well that the differences between men and women in personality are to be attributed primarily to biological factors. This isn't contentious. The only people it's contentious around are gender ideologues, and they've already lost the scientific battle, and so they've taken it to the legislative front to enforce their views. So they're really not contentious viewpoints. They're mainstream science, and I'm criticized all the time for spouting pseudoscience. It's like, it's not pseudoscience, it's mainstream science. And people who know the literature aren't disputing this. It's been known since the 1990s.
Well, then why are people whose views are not rooted in science, but instead in emotion and superstition, dominating our public conversation and punishing anyone who doesn't disagree? How do they get so much power?
Well,